We're the Rat Busters.
Now I can sit on the couch and I literally see two or three of them come out. And they're like, oh God, she's home.
Okay.
I'm curious why the other exterminators haven't been able to take care of this problem. I'm thinking there may be more to this than meets the eye. Is that all the information that you can think of that is pertinent to this?
I had a snake, and I think that's what was keeping them at bay.
Where's the snake now?
He got out.
He's gone. He vanished.
Yeah.
Okay. Are you kidding me?
I wanted a unique pet, something that not everybody had. So I decided on a red-tailed boa constrictor. His name is Troy, and he's 6.5 feet long.
What type of person loses a giant snake in their house? How does that happen?
Troy outgrew his 50-gallon fish tank, and we graduated to an open-air enclosure tank. It's giant. It's beautiful. It has plants in it, and he basically has more room to grow. So I go upstairs and I check all four corners of the cage, and he's totally gone. He's missing. He's MIA. We looked everywhere. He's just gone.
Let me tell you something. If I run into that snake in a dark corner, I quit. All right. Let's see what we got here. What do we got? Holy look at this. We might call the guys from Hoarders. Let them come first.
I can only imagine what's going through Jimmy's mind in this basement. He hates clutter.
I mean, this is just ridiculous down here. This is so much harborage. I mean, come on. There's droppings everywhere. And look at these flies flying around down here. And things are dying. I mean, there's just glue boards scattered all over the floor. I don't even know where to start here. I'm starting to learn how they could lose a 6.5-foot snake down here. I'm wondering if Jimmy Hoffa's buried down here.
I guess I'm a little bit of a hoarder.